Any other question?
So one thing I was thinking is, in the process of the process of the whole workshop, you have told that first step is to verify on our natural acceptance, and then go on those two parts, you know, living with the human being and living with the nature. But if natural acceptance is so sure, so do we really need to go on those second steps, or we can just verify on our natural base acceptance and we can say that yes, what is coming naturally to us?
Yeah, in fact, so when we say self-verification, so part one is verification on the basis of natural acceptance, right? If it does not pass the test, then it is not even worth trying, you know, to live with it. So this can be dropped, right? Only when this test is passed, right, then it is worth trying now, okay? So if not, discard. So it is not worth spending time on this. But if yes, then only it is worth trying to experiment in our life. Right? So that is what we are saying, that if it is not naturally acceptable, drop it anyway. If it is naturally acceptable, then I have to make sure that it is anyway going to ensure harmony within, because it is naturally acceptable to me. But then I have to make sure that it also leads to harmony with other. So the second part of the verification is to test, right, whether it leads to harmony with others. So one thing is sure, it is naturally acceptable to me, therefore it will lead to harmony with it. But then I have to check that does it lead to harmony with other. So if you look at the second part of the test, it is essentially asking this, you know, living accordingly, right? Which means behavior with human being. Leading to mutual happiness. So this is basically asking, does it lead to harmony with other human beings? Then asking, does it lead to harmony with rest of nature? That is mutual prosperity. So this first part is asking for harmony within oneself. So I must check both.
But on one end we are also saying that natural acceptance is a sort of universal thing. Okay, I have not realized it, but in the proposals at least it is being said that it is same for everyone and all. Then it is obviously going to come out that yes, it will lead to the mutual happiness.
Yeah.
And if somehow it is not coming, then I think I need to realize that what I am thinking, that this is natural acceptance, it might not be my natural acceptance, it might be coming from the acceptance or something like that.
So till you come to realize that natural acceptance is something universal, right? You have that confidence, right, that absolute self-confidence, it is better to verify both. That is part one. Part two, even after you have this confidence, you know, that you know that it is true, then you have to live with it anyway. So you have to work out the second part, right? Not with a doubt now, but with an assurance.
But how to do is, I think, answered by this second part.
No,
what to do?
Not really. What to do is answered.
What to do answer is the first part.
In the first part, what to do for myself. In the second part, what to do with the other. For example, when I come to know that, you know, this feeling of respect is what is naturally acceptable to me in relationship, right? This I can verify through natural acceptance. So I know that, yes, as far as I am concerned, the feeling of respect is naturally acceptable to me. Then I live with the other with this feeling of respect, and I find that it is fulfilling for me and fulfilling for the other.
But maybe the case, right, that the person not lead to mutual happiness. In that case, it depends on his conditioning actually.
No, that
but
is true.
My feeling is also comfort him. But
yeah, so this is what I am saying, that how to do is still different, you know. For example, when I am expressing this feeling of respect, I may say namaste, you know, or I say good morning, okay, or I fold my hands, you know, and welcome him to express my respect. So this is one way of expressing, right? The other person may have a different way of expressing, okay, but he will certainly accept my feeling of respect. He may not accept this particular way of expressing respect. And the problem is, when we start focusing on the way of expressing respect, then the feeling of respect. So we cannot be definite about the way of expression. There can be different way of expressing it, right? So how to do may be different, but what to do is definite.
Sure, but I am learning that. Okay, because past I, whatever I did, the behavior, that person is not required to express something. We have to work myself and my change my behavior. If we look in the period of the time, we will realize somehow to my actual change in my behavior.
Yeah, change in your behavior in terms of feeling? Instead of feeling, you have a feeling of disrespect?
I am not.
Will that be the change? Or instead of expressing respect through one mode, I may need to express it through another mode. So that may keep changing, but your natural acceptance for respect will not change. The natural acceptance of the other human being for respect will not change. Yeah, that is all.
See through my natural acceptance, not by seeing it.
No, I will see through my natural acceptance, and when I am behaving with the other, I will see whether prima facie is accepting it or not accepting it. And I may even ask him that I have this feeling of respect for you, will it be naturally acceptable to you? Or if I have a feeling of disrespect, will it be naturally acceptable? So if I have this clarity that feeling is definite, that is respect, expression may be different. Then whenever I go somewhere and I find that they are trying to express the respect in a different manner, right, I am able to see the respect even though the, you know, expression is not the same as my expression. And in due course of time, I am able to learn that expression, or at least I am able to understand that expression.